Hi, good evening. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Such huge apologies. We've had labourers here at Martinique Mansions, people trying to fix things, sort things for us, do things for us, you know, having our plumbing checked. And so we're late. Big apologies for that. Didn't mean to be late. We have got such a lovely show lined up for you this evening, boys and girls. Such a lovely show that, in fact, my hairstyle's decided it just wants to do its own thing. I mean, you can't even keep a hairstyle straight these days. Right, so good evening, good evening, good evening. Fiona Flange is here, Nita's here, lots of people are here already. Hi, hi, hi. Welcome and big apologies for being late. We're going to kick right off.
Evening, Liz.
By saying, oh, Liz is here too. Here we go. Liz is here too. Peppa is displaying her new gift from the gorgeous Liz. A gorgeous gift of a lovely embroidered
it's right, nails are going missing everywhere.
Oh, false nails are popping off everywhere, darling. Darling, darling, sweetie, darling, darling, darling. Don't know what's even going on up here.
Oh, we're in the library today, aren't
we're
we?
We're in the library. We're in the reading nook, actually. Our library is a bit bigger than this. This is just our little reading nook, you know, for want of a better word. And I'm now caught on my new dress. That's clever. Oh, dear. Oh, dear.
Oh, good evening, everyone, joining us tonight.
So who are our guests tonight, Peppa?
Who are our guests? Well, I've heard we've got a man on the show.
A man?
Yes.
Ooh.
The beautiful Phippipa Mann.
Phippipa Mann. Let's see where she is. Hold on. Lady Martinique's caught on her dress. Right. Phippipa.
Hi.
How are you, darling?
I'm good. Oh, you're in a library today.
We're in our library today. We're in our little reading room.
Well, if you're going to talk about reading, let's talk about, well, I'm not going to mention it, but we know what's good.
Oh.
But no, I can't even read anyway. I'm dyslexic.
Well, I was going to say, when we were all putting our makeup on and doing our thing, before I got attached to my dress, you were saying that you had a beautiful wallpaper behind you at the other residence you were at.
And I'd have you've just been
whisked over to the residence you're at now, but you were at another location, shall we say, doing your face. And you were saying...
Undisclosed locations.
Undisclosed, of course. And you were saying that you had no reading skill at all whatsoever, so you didn't understand
why we wanted to read.
Ah.
I can look at pictures and I can point at things and be like, oh, I would like that. Or this is pretty, but right. I can't tell you. Well, yeah, that, not the pretty part. Oh no, that is an inside joke between me and Peppa. Don't worry, darling. Oh no, you weren't looking. I called you at that. Anyway.
Nice, bitch.
Because we're in the reading room. We have to read.
We're in the reading room. We have to read. And in gay terms, for those of you that don't know, reading room is somewhere where you take your sisters and you put them to rights. You read them to rights and you let them know exactly how it is and isn't. So we're going to be back with you shortly. We're going to just go over to our other guest. Yeah. Bless her heart, is ready in record time this evening.
And it's catching.
And she's contagious. It is the gorgeous Chlamydia. Claire, darling. Oh, look at you.
Hi.
Get you.
How are we doing this evening?
You're looking all sexy and sultry there. Oh.
Yeah.
It's a bit of a fun thing going on.
Lucky I'm not a Lesbitarian. Hmm.
I know. Me too.
So, Chlamydia is joining us all the way from Newtown in Wales. I'm correct, Newtown?
All the way in Wales. That's correct. It is, yes.
In Wales. Even though you're from Manchester.
Yeah, I'm from Manchester.
So, you escaped the lockdown and moved to Wales how many years ago?
5 years ago.
Okay, so you and your man have been in Wales for 5 years. Happy there? Beautiful there?
It was absolutely gorgeous. We live in a tiny little valley and it's just full of hills, sheep and cows.
Amazing. Amazing, amazing, amazing. Now, we're going to look forward to some vocals from you later, so I'm told. So we will be chatting to you throughout the show, and then at different points we will allow you to do your numbers. So while you prepare for your first number, which will be in a little bit, we're going to go back to our main screen, so we'll catch up with you in a moment.
Bye.
Welcome. Right, so that was the lovely Claire. If you just put your microphone on mute, darling.
We can hear you using the toilet.
Toilet. So Peppa decided that it's actually 80s week this week. Bless her gorgeous cotton socks. Didn't tell anybody else. So I've come dressed like a Bond girl that needs a bit of bondage. And Peppa's come dressed as Cyndi Lauper on crack, which is great, you know. My baller is doing strange things. It's a gorgeous double stack that I've had done.
I did wonder where the cat went.
The cat is inside here propping it up. I told you, don't mention the cat. She's quite all right. She's got her milk and her cookies. In fact, in here you could have a whole kitchen sink, couldn't you? Love 80s Peppa, says Anita.
Aww, oh, thank
you. I'm going to pop some comments up on screen.
Thank you, Liz. You look gorgeous too.
I don't know what's going on with Ruth. Ruth says she's lost her ability to do something. Right, let's see where we go. So we've got Loving the Hair Ladies, oh. Hi Dolls,
Dollar Bits,
Hi Phillips. Don't know who that is.
Phippipa Mann.
Oh, gorgeous. Evening says Claire. Heidi's here. Heidi, hi.
Heidi.
Heidi, hi. Love 80s Peppa. Peppa, you look gorgeous. Yeah, Peppa's having an evening tonight. She's all themed up and ready to go. I'm wearing a little glitzy number by the Husbear. The Husbear decided to purchase me a gorgeous little... Well, I'm going as a glitter ball or a mirror ball from South Africa, if you will. You know, looking a little bit glitzy, a little bit glam. And the dress doesn't do much coverage down below. But, you know, it's always good to air one's patty. She can see everything. It's not like you haven't seen a vagina before, dear. Oh. Peppa's gag reflex is gone. Can't imagine why. Anywho. So, what have you all been up to? We'd love to know where you are watching us from. We were so thrilled, Peppa, to find that our viewership from last week on week, we kind of measure our viewership. We find out how many views we've had. And we are so, so grateful, so, so thankful to all of you for tuning in and for joining us week on week. Mm-hmm. And last week's viewership, up until Friday last week from the week before, was 1,900 viewers. And we thought that was fantastic. We thought we'd hit the ceiling, we'd hit the roof. That was great. It's a little show and we don't expect much. We love the fact that people view us and watch us and do things. But we don't have a lot of expectation. And boy, oh boy, were we surprised to find that our viewership for this week, up until yesterday, was sitting on 3,300 viewers. 3,300 viewers. Can you believe that? Peppa's now doing that for the deaf. She's also doing signing. So what do you think about the new COVID rules and the new tier system? No clue. I don't keep up to date with current events, unfortunately, but I am told it's not great. Fiona, we are told it's not great. So,
thank you, Claire.
We would love, love, love to hear what you guys think. Mm-hmm. What do you think? Oh, Nikki Stonham! Now, she's Martin's favourite niece.
Oh.
Yes, my friend Martin, she's his niece. She's gorgeous. Hello, babes. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Shafts My Berry, that's where Anita is from.
Mm-hmm. I think. Is that David fellow again?
Fanny ruined the ratings. Oh. Fanny will be back. Fanny will be here for our Hello Queen murder mystery. We have a murder mystery that Peppa's organized for us. Mm-hmm. It is going to be so much fun. There'll be six performers and it's going to be amazing.
And live. And nobody's going to know who the killer is.
We don't know who the killer is right until the end, apparently. We don't get the cliff notes on it. We just have to attend and take part.
Mm-hmm.
It's very strict. Peppa won't even let me read ahead. Rude. Rude. So, Shaft's My Berry Twice is Howard. And Nikki Stonham is watching from Bantown.
Mm-hmm.
And Janice MacDonald is watching from Durban in South Africa. Mm-hmm. Other than that, we'd love to know where people are watching from.
Yes, especially all these 3,300.
Heidi Millett says, it's me.
I know it's you.
Hello, it's me. Does she forget who she is? Is that the problem?
Sometimes.
Well, we're very, very happy to have you all here.
Mm-hmm.
Roll yes. over.
And anyone over that us. Joins us, watches the show on repeat, and has fun, please let us know who you are.
Hello, where Lisa you are. Swindles watching from Wales. You are the gorgeous lady whose photo we saw last week, because you're actually Johnny's sister. So she's related to Clair Mydia.
Ah.
Distantly related to Clair Mydia. We're not saying that Lisa has Clair Mydia, we're saying she's related to. Adjacent, yes. Not with.
Not close enough.
Not close enough to catch it. So welcome, welcome, welcome. So we are going to, where are you watching from? Murdersville, near Bridport. Is there such a place?
Well, one would imagine anywhere where David is.
Could Colchester. Be there's a Wimborne. There's a Sue Venus here. Hello, gorgeous.
Hey, Sue.
We like Sue Venus. She's that gorgeous, gorgeous lady. She has the most amazing readings based on drawings. You send her a drawing, you send her your Crayola crayon drawing, and she will analyze it for you. She is really, really good at what she does. Really, really good at what she does. I'm going to have to speak to my stylist. I really am. Right. And Leon is here. Now, Leon is related to Flexi Bell. Flexi Bell is a drag queen who will be with us in a couple of weeks' time. We are actually, what am I trying to say? We are actually being booked. People are wanting to be on the show rather than us looking for guests. People are now approaching us, which is great. And we can't wait to have Flexi Bell on the show. And she's got a little drink in her hand. We know she's drinking. What did she say she was drinking tonight? Vodka and Coke.
Yes.
Because she was on our pre-call. So we have backstage passes now. People were watching us get dressed and ask us all sorts of questions. And we were trying to answer as best we could. Chookers, teacups at the ready.
Yes, you're so right, David, when you say that Bridport is murder town.
Is it?
Yes, we were talking about that the other week, weren't we?
Were we?
Yes.
Linda's back.
Talking about that there David Tennant goes down there with the murders.
Ah. Well, Linda's back, our friend Linda, watching from Gill in the Ham.
Mm-hmm.
Loving it, Linda. Loving it. We would love to know, where are your teacups? Let's get Linda off screen so we can see our face. We would love to know.
Starting to disappear then.
Behind the, yes. We want to know where your teacups are. Yes. I want photos. We want photographic evidence sent
you
to our
with your teacup.
Message center. Send your photos to our message center. While you're at it, send us donations. We like that too. Let me find that thing. Please hold. Mm-hmm. We are accepting donations. There we go. And we're about to go back to Phippipa, and we're going to ask Phippipa some questions. So, Phippipa, darling, if you would take your mic off mute, and we will be coming to you. Let's just find Phippipa's ticker tape. Dum, dum, dum. There we go. And we're now going to go live to Phippipa. Darling, oh, sweetie.
Hello.
Hello, darling.
Got you.
What are you drinking?
I've got a Bailey's Red Velvet Cupcake.
Ooh.
Ooh. She's a whole lot of woman, that.
Mm.
It burns like ass. I hate it. But it's great. It tastes really nice.
Burns like ass.
You know, you have like a really good,
like our friend Annalise would know about that.
Well, you ever had like a really like good curry, and then the next day it's been a bit, you know, burns like ass. That's what I mean.
Lovely. So classy, our bitches, this evening.
Fuck. So it's burned.
The meat red velvet cake going on there,
so
I think.
Tell us a bit about Phippipa Mann. So how long have you been... How long have you been working the circuit, babes? How long have you been working as a woman?
Well, as a woman, I have been around for about a year and a half. No, yeah, about a year and a half-ish.
Right.
And I've just been knocking around Bournemouth, knocking around Poole, most of rural Dorset, so Dorchester and Weymouth, that sort of area, because I love a good farmer. Love a good farmer. Mm-hmm. And yeah. Very big hands. I have very little hands because I'm such a dainty little woman.
We know.
So I've just been doing that, really. I've been kind of out and about performing, you know, before COVID happened, like most of last year. And then this year, all my kind of bookings, I guess, were kind of null and void because of COVID. Mm.
Right.
Mm.
It's that horrible five-letter word that begins with C.
Yes.
Yeah, and I can't even spell it.
Tell us, where did the name Phippipa Mann come from?
Well, originally I was Cinderella.
Of course.
Because I was like, oh, it's like a princess. I'm really young. I'm not a queen. I'm a princess. So it's like Cinderella. And also, like, but I'm a guy. So it's like Cinderella. And then I was like, I want to sound more like a real name. But because it's like a pun behind it, you're like, oh, you got me, gal. You got me. So that's why Phippipa Mann was born.
Mm. Right. Well, I think it's a lovely name.
Yes.
I think it's gorgeous. I think it's practical. I think it has many uses. Mm-hmm. Filling a man has many uses. So you're drinking that. People are asking what we're drinking. So you're on the
Bellinis again.
Bellinis, and Bellini. I'm drinking spiced gold rum and lemonade.
All in a teacup.
Oh yes, of course. Very classy. Although when the camera's off, it's a bucket.
I am Lady Martinique, of course. And when you're with us, when we're holding court with our guests, here in our reading nook behind us,
well,
we do require people to have some decorum and etiquette, even though Pepper and I...
This wig is very Marie Antoinette, so I thought, well, if we're going to court...
Well, I did see regal nature from that.
Book. Oh yeah,
absolutely.
I think that was a trash.
In the world of drag, you're quite new, says us who are baby drag compared to you. Yes. But in age, you're also incredibly young. As a compliment, I would like to know
other fact.
What do you think? Because we can discuss your age, yes.
Yeah, I'm 20.
You're 20. She just turned 20 last week, so she had her birthday song from Bella. Want to know is, as a young emerging drag queen, how do you think the scene of drag is changing? Because you're quite up to date with drag lingo. You watch all the shows. You get involved in quite a few online competitions as well. Correct?
I did during lockdown, but because lockdown's kind of over now, I'm not involved with as many competitions.
Right.
But the competitions were actually a really nice way to see a lot of younger artists who don't get a platform already in the scene, because obviously the scene is obviously adult. So that's fun to see, because a lot of them are kind of, I don't want to say alternative, but they're more like not traditional women drag queens. They're painting themselves different colors, and they're going, you know, all different lengths and extremes to kind of look different and look cool and look unique.
Right.
Kind of the alien queens, clown queens.
Well, think, I mean, I like painting myself different colors. I mean, I never use like browns or like neutral tones in my makeup, because I feel it's a bit not boring in my, well, it sounds like I'm reading people now, no. no, but like, I'm not going to name any names, Miss Lady. But like, no, I like to use all the colours that are accessible in the world, like blues, your greens, your yellows, your pinks, your purples, orange, because they're available to you. And I mean, like naturally as a boy, I am, you know, pink and pale and flesh. Whereas I had the ability to paint myself, you know, green or yellow or orange and look really kind of cool and unique.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I mean, it's just wonderful to be able to kind of choose any colour from a spectrum and just go completely berserk with it.
Well, yeah, exactly, yeah.
Well, it's about using the whole palette, isn't it? And we were discussing earlier when we were doing the dressing room back chat that there's so many variations and permeations of drag now. Also, Claire, I don't know if Claire's listening in. Claire, are you listening? Claire was talking the other night and saying that it's so interesting. Yeah, she's listening. There we go. Claire was saying the other evening when she was doing her drag 5-hour long tutorial, she was saying that it's so interesting to watch different girls paint as well, because we all paint differently. We use different brushes, different products, different techniques. One of the questions that one of our club from tonight, one of the ladies tonight that was on the call, wanted us to ask you queens is, what kinds of products do you rate? What products do you use when you're looking at your makeup? What do you find?
I mean, you can get products at different kind of price ranges and stuff. Like, you can get really, really shit ones at, you know, like a higher price range, but you can also get really, really good ones at a really budget range. Like, I just do that. Like, my foundation normally when I do kind of natural makeup is Revolution, which you can get at Superdrug. I'm not out here trying to break my bank, you know, and it works for me, and it looks nice. I mean, if you wanted to, you could use, you know, your Kryolans or your Max, your Jeffree Star's, which would cost you an arm and a bloody leg. But I'll just use like drugstore products most of the time. I mean, a lot of my eye makeup or lip stuff is more kind of higher brand because they don't sell colorful stuff.
Yes.
At a low budget because of the budget range.
Well, how pigmented stuff at a low budget.
Stuff that studies.
Well, exactly. I mean, in this blue you wouldn't be able to get at Superdrug unless you found a really like decent brand. I think there was a brand that did a blue at one point for Halloween a few years ago. But it was very much like very, very sheer and very, very opaque and wasn't, you know, very good. So I was like, no, thank you, I'm all right. You know. Save your coins.
When you're kind of trying to find your look, to go out and buy all the cheap products is great, because you can, if you try something and it doesn't work for you, then it's only a pound you've lost.
Well, exactly.
Go and try something else. But certainly if you go out and spend a fortune on stuff, only to find out it doesn't work very well for you, then it's quite awkward, isn't it?
Well, exactly. I mean, I prefer using cheaper stuff because I know that I'll use it. I know that I will run out of it quicker if I like it enough. So if I find something cheap enough and I keep using it, then I'm not going to damage my bank that much by constantly having to buy the same product over again. If that's like a fiver, for example.
Yeah.
Whereas if I run out of like Jeffree Star's, you know, liquid, whatever the stuff, I'm now like, right, now I've got to save me pennies until I can, you know, get it again, which will be for another good 3 moons. You know?
I also think that whilst you're developing your drag, probably the best thing to do is to play around with the cheaper products to find the look you want to go with or the style you want to go with. When I first bought my first load of stuff for my drag, which was about 2 months ago, I only bought silver, black, white, like metallic colors, because I was convinced that I was only going to wear gray wigs. And I was not going to paint in color. I was going to paint in like gold, silvers, metallics, etc., and kind of stick to a neutral palette, but in a minerals kind of vibe. And then I was going to wear lots of gold, silver, black, and white. And then within like a week, I bought God knows how many dresses in different colors. And I thought, oh shit, now we need to do color. So I think it's good to play with, as you say, less expensive items, but it's also important to say a lot of less expensive items are actually very good quality.
They are completely cool. Agree.
So we're going to give you a chance to have another swig of your drink.
Oh good, I was getting a bit thirsty.
I've got something that will cause a little bit of stir.
Am I going to go now?
Let me delve in my box.
There's a stir coming.
There's a right stir coming.
A stir in your box, did you say? Madam.
Yes, in my box, as if by magic. Here is some absolutely wonderful, and you It's not the green screen. It's the image isn't showing. These are some tropical neon eyeshadows that are old enough to be your mother.
They came over on the Titanic.
And that was before they even got to heaven.
Well, now, as they did way back then, in the 80s.
So she bought those in the 80s. Mm-hmm. Before you were even a twinkle, darling.
Yeah.
Not even a twinkle.
So, you know, it does go to show that sometimes the cheap stuff can be really good.
So, Phippipa, are you ready for Claire's first song?
I am.
Singing for us. We're all getting for her song. While Claire is singing, ladies and gents, don't forget, I'm going to pop up Claire's ticker tape underneath. Phillippa's details are underneath at the moment. Every time we go to our guests, Phillippa, I've spelled man wrong. I didn't put the double.
No, but I can't read it, so.
Oh, it's okay. I spelled the dyslexic version. It's all right. But I will fix that. While Claire is performing, we will pop up some messages that you've all sent in during this chat. Mm. So if Claire is ready, Phillippa, if you just pop your mic on to mute again, darling, so we don't hear you guzzling.
Yes.
I don't guzzle, I sip. I'm a lady. I don't do ladies' things.
Not what I heard, not what I saw on YouTube. Ooh, bye now. We're going to go back to the gorgeous Claire. Claire Mydia joining us all the way from Wales. We're going to do a couple of things. So, Claire, while we talk to you and get you ready, we're going to look at the banners quickly. We're going to change over to Claire's banner. Claire, let me tell you, our production crew, you know, it's huge. We've got cameramen, we've got tech crew. It's me.
Same here, I've got light engineers, cameramen, sound effects, all the works, you know.
Husband of yours, and your sister is watching this live.
Hi, Lise.
She's watching. She was watching earlier on, and we tried to tell her that she wasn't related to chlamydia because it can be contagious, so she's just chlamydia adjacent. But she didn't think it like that. She said, no, she's definitely related to you.
Yeah.
But isn't it lovely to have her support? I've got my niece watching from South Africa, so that's lovely.
Fabulous.
So we are going to chat. Oh, hang on. We are going to chat to you a minute. For a minute. So, chlamydia, the name, where did that come from?
When I decided I was going to do drag, I decided I want a name that's unique, that nobody else has got, and it's a play on words. And it took me a long time, but I came up with Claire Mydia, and I thought, do you know what? I'm having it. It's mine. It's
good.
It's me. It's who I am. And that's it. Just, after about 3 or 4 weeks of trying to decide on something, it was Claire Mydia. It was going to be Joanna Broome.
Yeah.
In Manchester, that's the first thing somebody says to you when you go in their house. Do you want a brew? So far. But now I decided on Claire Mydia.
Cool. Well, I think it's a lovely name.
Oh, thank you, my darling. Yeah. She's a dirty little redhead, she is.
Dirty little redhead. I like you in red.
I do.
I know you sent us a lot of your promo pics from your professional photo shoots.
Oh, and, yes.
You look a little bit like Pink in the is it the grey wig or like a blonde wig that you wear? It looks short. You look a little bit like Pink, the artist. And I was like, oh no, I prefer you as a redhead. So that's why we ended up using your redheaded photo. So if those of you that want to support Claire, all her details are below. Your cat's behind you.
Pussy.
Your pussy's behind you, Claire.
It's behind you.
The other night, Claire was doing a makeup tutorial, and the cat jumped on the table next to her. She nearly died. She got such a fright.
Gave me the fright of my bloody life.
Naughty pussy.
Hello, Guava Barbie. She's here. I'm just running through messages, Claire. Otherwise, we end up at the bottom. There we go. Claire looks beautiful. That's for you, Claire.
Thank you, Liz.
Beautiful. Looking good, ladies. This is Jenny Carroll. Hey, Jenny. And I think we're at the bottom of where we are. Love Claire's hair, says Heidi. Amazing. Try Oriflame. I know that's a product.
It's a makeup brand, a bit like Avon.
Okay.
It's a Swedish makeup brand, Oriflame.
Cool. Well, she's saying we should try it. So, lucky us. So what are you going to sing for us first, Claire?
I'm going to sing One Night Only.
Amazing. Now, I heard Claire sing in another show that a friend of ours hosts this week, and I messaged you, didn't I, straight afterwards and said, yeah. Wow, what an amazing voice you have. So I'm really thrilled. I'm trusting that the gods of Facebook are not going to cut us out. And if they do, fuck them, because your voice is absolutely phenomenal. So go on, guys. Send in your messages for Claire as we go to her live. Anita wants to know if she can stroke your pussy, Claire. Think about that while you sing.
Anytime.
It's easy, pussy.
She's not fussy. Right,
she's
darling.
She's not a fussy
pussy. She's not a fussy pussy. Right. So if you're ready.
I'm ready, yeah.
You may begin, my darling. This is Claire Mydia singing One Night Only. Trying to remember 400 things. You've got this fan of yours, your sister, who has said all sorts of things. We've had a wow for you. We've had a you go girl. We've had a Claire, you are great.
Oh,
amazing. Colin says hi. Thomas says hi. Heidi says go go Claire.
Thank you.
Amazing! Bloody amazing!
Bloody great, I tell
you. You're fucking right, fantastic. Grand. Right, grand.
No, fabulous, that one.
It was lovely. Mm. So, why one night only?
I love that song ever since seeing it in Dreamgirls. I didn't know Dreamgirls was a Broadway. I just thought it was a film. I've seen, obviously, the one with Beyonce and Jennifer Hudson.
Yes.
But yeah, seeing it in that, and I just absolutely loved it. It's just something that's resonated with me, so I thought, why not? Why not so, sing it?
She's losing earrings. She's losing the plot.
Stuffing's coming out.
Everything's happening. Everything's happening tonight. It's because I was on that pre-call, Claire, with all those people making noise. So, yeah. Nikki is my niece. She's called in all the way from South Africa. Stunning Claire, yes.
Yes.
So you're international now, darling. You're in Africa. Howard's giving you lots of claps.
He likes giving people lots of claps.
He likes giving people the clap. Mm.
I like giving people the clap.
Ooh! You all look amazing tonight, and Claire, well done. Mm-hmm. Wow. So lots and lots of comments coming in for you there, Claire. We do have a 10-second delay, funnily enough. So when we're talking live, it takes 10 seconds for the audience to hear it. I think it's for, so you can cut off if there's a problem or whatever, you know, for safety measures. So often the comments will come in after the song. Claire, I did chat with you in the week. Obviously, we had a couple of chats this week, and I chatted with your boy self, but you said you were quite happy for us to discuss one of the things you shared in your profile when you sent us your information for the show was that you actually suffer with mental health as your boy self.
Yes.
And you were quite happy to speak about it and quite open about it. And although we don't need to go into the ins and outs of what you particularly suffer with, I said to you, I was particularly interested to know how you feel your drag helps you to deal with that or to process that. Do you feel drag has given you a coping mechanism or a tool?
Oh, definitely. For me, drag, it's an escape. When I'm in drag, where I'm Claire, I'm completely separate to Johnny. I'm a completely different character, different way of thinking. So, being able to get into drag enables me to be somebody that I'm not necessarily able to be on my own. Mm. If that makes sense. It gives me the confidence and the power inside to be a fierce-ass sassy bitch. Whereas when I'm Johnny, I'm always second-guessing myself, always thinking, did I say something wrong, did I not say something right? This, whereas as Claire, I really couldn't give a flying F.
Now, do you get that thing that I do? Whenever I'm out shopping, and as not Peppa, and I'm actually shopping for Peppa stuff, and I slip into that mind frame and actually start walking differently and thinking differently and kind of have that voice in my head going, no, Peppa wouldn't wear that. Peppa wants this.
So Rosanna Saltfleet, who is one of our one of my close friends, he's actually a male singing performer here in Bournemouth. He does a lot of the hotels. We're actually going to have him on the show as one of our guests soon, as a boy. Don't worry, Ross, as a boy. You don't have to be a girl. He's going to be one of our music guests in the weeks to come.
Fabulous.
He doesn't know it yet. He says, sing again more. And he's got the most beautiful tenor voice. We sing in the same voice group when we do shows together. So you've got high praise indeed from Ross.
Fabulous.
Claire, so since you've developed Claire, so how long has Claire been in existence now?
Claire's been in existence for about a year now.
Okay. And so since Claire's come around, have your family and friends noticed a change in Johnny? Has it helped Johnny to be Johnny with Claire being your alter ego?
They noticed that I'm a lot more together, and I think that's only because of the fact that I've got something to focus on, something I'm putting my mind to. I'm always thinking about my next look, my next gig, what I'm going to do, wear, makeup, blah, blah, blah. So I've always got something to focus on.
So Claire actually helps you to stop second guessing yourself and allows you the freedom to be yourself.
Definitely. And well, do you know what? It might be a bit too much information, but one of the things I'm suffering with is depression. And part of that depression is sometimes I don't want to get out of bed. Sometimes I don't want to bathe. I don't want to, do the daily tasks that everybody does and takes for granted. When you're suffering with a mental health issue, it is 10 times harder to do that. It's 10 times harder to lift that sheet up and actually get out of bed. But when you've got to have a positive mental attitude, positive mindset, and when you've got something to look forward to and something to work for, it makes that a lot easier. Makes things a lot easier to cope with. It makes your day-to-day life easier to cope with.
Yeah, you're so right.
It does for me anyway.
Well, we commend you for it. We think what you're doing is just fantastic, and we couldn't be prouder of you, and not in a patronizing way, because you just were so open about it when you sent in your information to me and you said that these are the things you suffer with. And as you will attest to, I haven't just ambushed you tonight. I actually did call you and say, would you be okay with discussing this? Because part of what Peppa and I are trying to do, as we know, Peppa is actually a female in her real life, and I'm a male in my real life, but what we wanted to do as a collective was to just really expose people to all the variations of drag that are out there and the different reasons as to why people do drag. So some people like yourself are doing it not only just to be fabulous, but also as a coping mechanism to deal with things that you as Johnny would suffer with on a day-to-day basis.
Definitely.
I do think that you have the most phenomenal voice, and I've sung professionally for most of my life. And I really, really, really look forward to us having you down here in Bournemouth in our drag show that we're going to be hosting as of next year. We're going to be doing our Tenor Ladies at Large shows.
I can't wait.
And we're looking for guest performers, and really, really are looking forward to hosting you here in Bournemouth and having you here with us, because that would be absolutely gorgeous. Let's see what's going on here. Great hair, Claire, says Howard Parfitt. Michelle Arrowsmith says, loving the live music. Rob wants to know where his invite to come on is. Yes, Rob, sure. Lisa, that's your sister, your gorgeous sister. We love you.
We love you too.
We like her. She can stay. We like her lots. Yes. Megan Garford, good on you, chick. You look amazing, Claire Mydia. Amazing. Claire, when you go off screen, why not start a watch party from your page, and then people can join in and watch the rest of the show?
The merrier.
Fabulous. Invite the whole family along. We want to try and top 3,300, which was our score for this week. And the more we can give girls' exposure, the more we're all going to be able to benefit, because you yourself said you live quite rurally in Wales in the valley. There's not much of a circuit out there for you.
Not so this is really
a nice opportunity for you as well, which we just absolutely love. So we're going to pop you backstage to get ready for your second song, have a stiff drink, adjust your bra, do all those things. Our audience are waiting for you to perform again. And fabulous. So we are going to go back to ourselves on screen. Don't forget to pop your mic on mute, darling. Right. So Michelle Arrowsmith Michelle Arrowsmith is crying. Michelle's husband, Rob, is a phenomenal performer. The end of sentence.
Phenomenal.
He's a phenomenal performer. Rob performs incredibly well. Obviously, his nose is put out of joint because he's not been asked to. Maybe we'll do a magic segment, Rob. You can come on and do a magic show for us.
Make Lady M disappear.
Cheeky bitch. That's it. Your Christmas wages are docked.
You were actually going to pay me at Christmas.
No, but they're docked. Right, so where are you watching from in the world? We'd love to know.
Yes, all you secret viewers, all you viewers that watch when we're not live.
Yes.
Tell us who you are, where you are.
Send us dirty messages. Send us dirty messages.
Yes, no pictures, just messages.
Yes, no pictures. We don't need to see your winky Jana.
No.
We're allergic to those.
Or your bottom.
Or your front bottom. Or your booberellas.
No. We. Can anybody see us?
Wave if you can hear us. Wave.
Oh, yes. Good. We're getting waves from backstage.
We're back.
Oh, told you not to leave your waxer plugged in.
Don't know what happened there. Who's trusted two queens with technology? I mean, really? Can you ever? Oh, lights on the subject.
Oh, bless. Adam's just told us we're gone. Yes, we're totally gone.
Completely lights on the subject. Gone. Oh, dear. Right, we're back. Never trust two queens with technology. Clearly, we unplugged ourselves somehow. I mean, really? So, welcome back. I hope you enjoyed your commercial break.
Yes.
Hopefully
the library.
Hopefully you went and... Clair Mydia's banner is still running. Hopefully you went and made a donation to our PayPal, because clearly we need donations to keep running because our electricity ran out. We had to take our little card to the Lecky meter and put more electricity on. I mean, really. Really, really, really. So, I found that quite informative.
Yes. Yes.
I think that it's really brave of Claire to chat about what she's going through. But also, I think it's really brave for us to discuss things. And we were discussing something earlier with the group that was watching our backstage getting dressed and getting ready, because one of the ladies asked a question, and she said, I'm so sorry to ask this question, and I really want to ask. And we actually said, you know, we'd rather that you ask questions, as long as they're asked tactfully and genuinely, without any malice or any funny business. We're happy to answer questions on absolutely anything and everything. So one of the questions, we had some questions that our viewers put to us earlier, and we are going to be do that in a little bit. People are saying they can see us. We're so glad you can see us. Go into another room. Well, as you know, at Martinique Manor, we have a lot of room.
You've got to move all this camera gear.
Just too lovely. Back in the room. Refilling our cups. Where's Lady Martinique's puppies? They're right here. They're right here. My puppies are in exactly where they're meant to be.
It's covering your puppies.
Oh, Sue's covering our puppies.
Yes.
Oh, well, maybe if I don't go in that direction. There we go. Oh, dear. Now the name is covering the puppies. There are my puppies.
Shoot.
Right. Now that I've exposed my breastuses to the whole world, let's see what's going on. There's a private chat going on. What's happened? I can't see you. Flipper man, we can see you. Cheeky bitch, you're back on screen. Unmute yourself.
Hello. I have. Is it your hearing?
Sorry?
Is it just your hearing? Exactly.
Rude. So what we want to know from you, Phippipa, is what did you think of their performance?
I couldn't even think.
She's
blown away by
it.
Incredible.
Well, your wig is blown.
It's
moulded into a nice style.
Yes, it is. But no, Claire was incredible.
Woman.
I know Claire can hear
me. It was incredible.
And
she's
it was brilliant.
Really gifted.
We love it.
Good. You know, you've heard it here first, ladies and gents. Phippipa Mann thought it was brilliant, and she couldn't even speak. Some would say that's a blessing. Maybe they should bring Clair Mydia around to sing around you more often. Love you, sis. Love you.
I know.
Love you.
You can be a right bitch.
So, in the classification of queendom,
yes.
What kind of queen do you see yourself being? So, I'm also a singing queen. So, I'm probably a cabaret queen. You're probably cabaret and comedy.
A WTF queen.
Right. So, where do you see yourself, Phippipa?
I don't know. I mean, I lip sync. I dance. I sing live. I write my own sort of like songs and raps and stuff because, you know, I'm like just so creative. I paint myself different colors, but I'm not like a fashionable look queen. I'm also like non-binary, so like I guess like
Woo!
Sort, So I guess it's like, I don't know, maybe your alien leader coming to Earth to bless you, to bless the children.
I like that. Mm-hmm. I like that at your age, and it's going to sound patronizing, but it certainly isn't, but I like that at your age of 20, mm-hmm. you have more of an idea of who you are than I think I had at the age of 20. I think I was still, you know, finding my navel.
I think... No, I think it comes to like the social media side of things. Like, because I'm so young, I have access to a lot of social media, and I can see people who are like me or who are different from me, or find out things quicker because I can see it just by tapping my phone and stuff, you know?
Yeah.
So I think with that, I think it's way easier for people my age to actually be, you know, non-binary, different, and everything else that's out there that you wouldn't have learned about even 10 years ago, really.
Yeah. I mean, you're so right. I mean, I'm a NB myself, and I didn't make that discovery until I was 48. Getting quite old. Yeah.
Good, like 1,000 years ago. Okay.
Yes. Noted. Oh, yes, exactly. But yeah, it's kind of one of those things that you always, I certainly myself, I always felt different, but I didn't quite know what different was at the time.
Yeah.
And certainly back in that time, it was kind of, if you were very mask presenting, you're obviously a lesbian.
Yeah.
And I kept thinking to myself, but I don't like women in that way. I like men.
Yeah.
So obviously now we've got all these spectrums that have come out, which are absolutely wonderful, and people can actually find somewhere where they belong. And it's not one of those things that you get your passport stamped and you're that for the rest of your life.
Absolutely.
Exactly. Amen.
You know, it's, life's fluid. Life's all about change. So
exactly.
And gender-based.
Thing, I feel like drag used to be very stereotypical of like, oh, it's a man in a wig. You know, kind of.
Oh,
what was that I asked?
Well, his social media is man in a wig. Double N, I've corrected it during the break. I corrected your banner.
I wouldn't have known because I can't read. We've been over this. God. that old age of yours, lady.
Not getting any brownie points.
Don't you even read Braille?
No, I can't see. I can't read, that's why.
Read by feeling.
Ah, there we go.
Correct.
What was I even saying?
Who knows? You were talking about fluidity.
Yeah, so drag used to be like, you know, the very typical, like, you know, some old man in a basement singing your cabaret songs to a bunch of drunk men in a, you know, a dingy bar type of thing, with your feather boas and your frocks and your gowns, your sequins and whatnot. But I think over the last decade, not naming any names, but just a decade ago, it started to evolve into more fashion or more kind of anything really. Like, you know, I mean, the club kids who were more prominent in America, I think, than the UK, who were, I guess, these freaks, I use in quotation marks, in a positive way, obviously, but they were out there painting themselves to look just like an illustration out of a novel. And to me, that's incredible. Like live your fantasy, girl, like live it. I mean, right now I'm a yellow Marie Antoinette.
It's a work of art, isn't it?
Exactly. I mean, I'm a Marge Antoinette, you know?
Marge Antoinette. Loving that.
That's an episode I'd like to see.
Yes.
Oh, well, they did a Drag Race episode with Ruined Raja on The Simpsons. Did you watch that one?
Yes, I did.
It was okay.
Yes, I did.
it was okay. That's it.
The end.
Period.
So where next for you?
Probably to bed. I'm very, very tired. No, well, that's
good luck for your business. We're next to you to bed. Line up, boys. I'm ready.
Yeah.
Yeah. Line up. Come on. Oh, no, but only if there's six of you from two different households because of the new rules. Other than that, book in advance.
Yeah.
And track and trace. You didn't get it from me. No, but yeah, I think the future, I think I want to be kind of doing more creative looks, doing my kind of music, writing my stuff, performing more. Because for a while I wouldn't actually sing live in drag because I have more of a deeper voice. It, to me, I was like, oh, I'm a lady in drag. I'm a woman, breasticles, you know, everything. I'm a lady. Women don't sound with deep voices. How dumb was I? Like, not my name. But I was, you know, kind of very self-doubted, very kind of anxiety about that one. Kind of being like, oh, I shouldn't sing live. I should have more of like a demure voice, you know. Kind of going on myself a little bit, which is weird for a drag queen to kind of do that. The thing is, we're dressed up like this, you know.
Yeah.
But I think for the future, I think I want to be working on my musical stylings, you know, and that sort of thing, really, kind of progressing in what I wanted to do when I was a child, which was to be a pop sensation, you know, but as all kids do, you know. Me and everyone else in the room, like.
So your nan said you could sing well, so that's it, you've got a career for life. Yeah.
My nan said I look great on stage, and now I'm set for life. I love it. Literally that.
Gotta trust a nan.
Yeah, nana knows best.
That's why I don't trust Lady Martinique, because she's not a nana.
No.
She is mother.
No, she's mother. That's what you are, you're mother.
Mother. But I do have some grandchildren.
You do.
My niece who's watching right now is 34 years old and she's got two daughters. So I've got great nieces. Can you believe that?
Well, by the colour of your hair, I can believe it, but...
You cheeky bitch.
From your face, I can't believe it's not butter.
This is... Oh dear, there's a problem with this connection. We're going to have to put you backstage. Like we didn't...
No, please. I didn't mean it.
Fanny Craddock, we put her backstage two weeks ago, because she was naughty. So we just said, oh, bye, bitch, and took her backstage.
There we go. Somebody wants to hear you rap.
Oh, okay. Ooh. I have lyrics on my phone. Oh, my God, work.
Do you want to prep that while we chat to Claire when we come back to you?
Yeah, that'd be great. That'd be great. I'd love to do that. Oh, my God, yeah.
We'll give you a little rehearsal period and go.
Excellent, love that.
You can do a rap for us. Yay!
Yay!
Bye, babes.
Peace out.
Well, it's us again. Me and my sister, Peppa Sprey, coming to you live. My niece keeps saying, when is Lady Martinique going to sing? Not this week, my darling. Not this week. I am actually writing a one-woman show where I'll be singing my way through my life. Peppa says it'll have to be like a trilogy because there's too much of a life to sing about. But what does Peppa know? Anyway, Phippipa rap, yes. Phippipa to rap, yes. Can we see Bella? No. And why? Because I'm wearing a sequined dress and she is currently sleeping on Peppa's hoodie. So Peppa's going to go home with a fur coat.
I'll be smelling of dog.
Which is different from normal how?
Smelling of fish. Lady M's lost it.
Oh, my aching ovaries. Oh dear, we need to go back to Claire. Claire, rescue me.
Don't you know it, Liz?
Where's Claire?
She's hiding.
Oh, Claire, come back to us. Claire,
sister. I'm here. To the rescue.
To the rescue. Oh my God.
I think it's time for a lovely cup of tea, don't you?
What are you drinking in your teacup, love?
Gin and lemonade.
Ooh.
Because she's classy.
Very
like
nice.
That.
It's fruit tea.
That's fruity. We always say it's fruity. Mother's ruin. Exactly. That's darling, what are you going to sing for us next? Tell us.
I'm going to sing Walking in Memphis.
Fabulous.
I love that one.
Now, before we go to that, one of the questions we had earlier, I don't know if you were on screen with us, because we were all doing our faces together, weren't we? Well, trying to. And there was a lot of chatting going on in the background with the guests that we had joining us backstage for their backstage passes. And I think you were off screen when I asked the ladies what would they like to ask of our guests this evening. And one of the prominent questions was, how would you as a drag queen, what are you, drag screen? drag queen. And
you've been sipping
two.
Too much. Captain Morgan.
How would you as a drag queen, what are you happy to do for baby queens coming through? So do you have a drag daughter? Are you helping younger queens?
I'll be completely honest with everybody that's watching. I'll probably be one of the most helpful people you will ever meet. When I started drag, I had to learn everything the hard way. Didn't know a thing about makeup at all. I literally spent, like we talked about earlier, Claire's been around for 3 years, but I've actually been for 1 year, but I've actually been doing makeup for 3 years. I spent a good 2 years learning my face, learning what looks good, what doesn't. And throughout that process, I now know for myself what is a good product, what isn't a good product. I can also, the first thing I noticed about somebody when I look at them now is their eyebrows. Because when I first started, eyebrows was one of my biggest crutches. So I spent so much time on my eyebrows that whenever I meet a new person, that is the first thing I notice. Some people will notice somebody's shoes or something like that when they first meet somebody. But for me, it's eyebrows. Yes, going back to the other question, I do have a drag daughter. She's called Sylvia Suckalot.
Yes.
And we're just in the process of... At the moment, I'm currently painting her face, but we're in the process of she's learning what's going where and the different eye shapes that we can do. But yeah, I'm very helpful. So if anyone wants any help or advice, come this way. My face isn't an expensive face of makeup. My face is a cheap face of makeup. It's just about how you use the product.
Yes, I think, and how you learn how the product...
I think you need to put your teeth back in tonight, Lady M. Blub, 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 blub.
It's her. Well, you need to be in studio with her. Fuck my life. Right, so...
Stop tickling Lady M tuppence.
Yes, stop tickling me tuppence. You can almost see my tuppence. This dress isn't very long. It's air conditioned, dear.
Yes. very hair conditioned.
What Anita was asking earlier was, like, you know, talking about... helping younger queens. But I remember the other night when I watched your extensive makeup tutorial with Lady Ford, the both of you were talking about how, and it's true, sadly it's true, so let's have a moment of silence, how a lot of us have found that a lot of drag queens that are established can be quite bitchy and quite possessive over their knowledge. They're not happy to share tips, tricks, and so therefore we had to stumble through. Luckily we had each other. We started at the same place. Although Kat is a woe man in the flesh.
Who?
A woe man.
Kat, Pepper's sister.
Yeah.
Although Kat is a woe man in the flesh, Kat doesn't ordinarily wear makeup. So when Pepper came to be, Pepper needed to learn what her drag style and signature was going to be.
Definitely.
So we both fumbled around and helped each other with our makeup techniques. Makeup techniques. I'm not a lesbian. Stop trying. you guys were saying that people weren't incredibly helpful and it was incredibly difficult to get genuine sisters out there. And
it was because they're established, they were kind of a bit up themselves, so to speak.
Yes.
I didn't see like what the need for it was, because we're all started, you know, at the same place, and we're all on this journey. Some of us are a bit further along this journey than others. So how hard is it to help somebody? How hard is it to send a message back? Do you know what I mean? I'm not going to be one of those people. Like I said, I had to learn everything about makeup the hard way. I had to learn it for myself. through practice, through watching tutorials, through doing it, and then wondering, why doesn't mine look like that? And then changing, you know, it's a constant process of review and growth. That's what it's been for me anyway. And if anybody wants any help with anything drag related, I'll offer what help I can.
Amazing. Thank you. What I was going to say to you was, I have no idea. Yes, help and assistance is always there. And that's what I was going to say, was that Peppa and I are hoping that through the show, people can make contacts and meet new people and discover what their drag is or what their drag aesthetic is.
Yeah.
Or even just discover that, guess what, not all of us are absolute bitches.
Exactly. I always say drag, it's like opening a box of Pringles, because once you pop, you can't stop. Once you get into drag for that first time and you feel yourself, it's an addiction. You don't want to go back. And, you know, like for me, it's an addiction. It's something that I want to continually improve and get better and better at.
Yeah. Very, very cool. I'm just reading what's going on here, because people are... As you can tell, all our technicians are busy on the call at the moment. Are you doing a ginger spice to Peppa one-woman show? Are you going to do a one-woman show, ginger spice?
No, it's you writing your one-woman show.
Oh.
Are you going to leave me?
Oh, what? No, I thought she was asking you if you were...
Someone looks like you want her.
Claire, I think we better let you sing, my darling. Mm. Hold on, there's messages for you first.
Oh, let's have a listen.
Liz says, Claire, you're so lovely.
Sorry.
Lisa says, beautiful soul. That's your sister.
Thank you, sis.
Add me to the live if you can. We can't add you to the live, Wendy, unfortunately, because we've already gone live. We have seen Claire on Instagram, and she's amazing. Yes, she is. Have you seen her Instagram looks? Work, girl, work.
I'm waiting on getting some more hair, because I have kind of, like, you know, got its worth out of this wig. It's literally been in every single look that I've had. But I'm just currently waiting on a couple of them being done, so we'll have a bit of a change soon.
Lovely. So you're going to sing what for us now?
Walking in Memphis.
Walking in Memphis. So we're going to hand over to Claire Mydia, who is going to be singing Walking in Memphis. Do follow her. Leads at the bottom. All her links are at the bottom. And you can find Claire at all those places. Go on, Claire. Give it to us.
Thanks, Lady Anne.
Shoes and I boarded the plane. Touchdown in the land of the Delta Blues, in the middle of the pouring rain. WC ended, won't you look down over me? I say, yeah, I got a first class ticket, but I'm as blue as a girl can be. Then I'm walking in Memphis, walking with my feet 10 feet off the field, walking in Memphis. Do I really feel the way I feel? I saw the ghost of Elvis on Union Avenue. I followed him up to the gates of Graceland, and I watched him walk right through. Now security, they did not see him. They just hovered around his tomb. There's a pretty little thing waiting for the key down in the jungle room. And I was walking in Memphis, walking with my feet 10 feet off the field, walking in Memphis. Do I really feel the way I feel? They got catfish on the table. They got gospel in the air. And Reverend Green, be glad to see you when you haven't got a prayer. But boy, you've got a prayer in Memphis. Now Gabriel plays piano every Friday at the Hollywood. And they brought me down to see her, and they asked me if I would do a little number. And I said with all my might. She said, tell me, are you a Christian child? And I said, man, I am tonight. Walking in Memphis, I was walking with my feet 10 feet off the hill. Walking in Memphis, do I really feel the way I feel? Walking in Memphis, I was walking with my feet 10 feet off the field. Walking in Memphis, do I really feel the way I feel? Put on my blue sweet shoes and I boarded the plane. Touchdown in the land of Delta Blue, in the middle of pouring rain. Touchdown in the land of the Delta Blue, in the middle of the pouring rain.
Thank you, ladies.
We want to be your backup dancers.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, definitely. Come on.
So I don't know if you got a chance to read those messages. Did you see them?
No, no.
She was in the zone.
We've had a... we've seen Claire on Instagram. She's amazing. We love the Ursula wig.
Thank you.
Sylvia Sokolot says, you are working it tonight, mother. Mm-mm.
Thank you, daughter.
My niece said, OMG, Claire, you're amazing. Love it. Wishing you all the happiness you deserve. Keep smiling. Smiling like the star that you are.
Keep love smiling.
Amazing.
Smiling.
Brilliant.
Oh, thank Lady you, everyone.
M and, Lady M and Pepper, interpretive dance.
Yes.
Interpretive dance.
I'm a tree.
So, Claire, when we were chatting the other night...
A tree.
Claire, when we were chatting the other night, before we go back to Phippipa, so Phippipa, this is your five-minute call. Before we go back to Phippipa, when we were chatting the other night, we were chatting about you singing, and she's awful tonight. I just moved, and you could almost see my Taco Bell.
I mean, you keep that Taco Bell in the wrapper.
I've tucked in everything. I mean, it's just a bit of sequin, really.
Now, would you believe it or not, right, but at about 3 o'clock today, I was contemplating ringing you to cancel, because for the past 3 days, I have had the most horrible fucking cough. No, it's not COVID, it's not continuous, but I've had the most horrible cough. And I've been saying to me, to Sylvia and to Lisa, I'm like, what am I going to do? I don't want to cancel. I'm not that person. Blah, blah, blah. So all day today, I've been drinking cough medicine bottles and sucking menthol sweets.
I told you the other day what you needed to do.
Pardon?
I told you the other day what you needed to do.
Yeah.
Do you remember what I told you?
Oh, Jesus. Remind me.
I said, I think you've got sexolitis and you need a spermicidal injection.
That's the one, the spermicidal injection. I had 3 and they didn't work. Still had a bit of little over, so I just put it on my cheek as a highlighter.
Oh, fuck, I love you.
Flakes off.
I just love you. Right, listen now.
I love you too, and I really appreciate you both having me on the show.
Well, it's lovely attention. Now, what I was going to say before I got so interrupted by my Taco Bell story was, I was going to say, you've got such a lovely voice, as we've already said, and so many people agreeing with us, and that's good. And I said to you a couple of nights ago when we were chatting, I think after the show, and I said, so where do you want to take this? And you said, I really and truly believe that I would like to go far with this. And I can see myself singing in front of lots of people, performing out there, doing it. And I think so many queens today want to put on the look and put on the attitude, but don't actually have a vision for where they want it to go.
They just want to dress up and look pretty.
And they want the instant fame. You know, they want the instant Instagram fame or the instant whatever it is, TikTok, whatever the thing is. And people don't even develop their characters. They don't know who they are. You know, Lady Martinique is from Africa, and she's 69th in line to the throne. She's just waiting for 68 people to die first. You know, she's immigrated to the UK. Peppa Sprey used to be on an off Broadway show. Very Broadway show. And, you know, we know who we are as individuals because we've developed character. And we want to see it go further. And like we said to you, we're going to have this drag cabaret show. But really lovely to know that you'd like to take it far. And I really and truly believe in my heart of hearts that you have got what it takes, babe. Mm-hmm. You really, really do.
I'm going to take it as far as it can possibly go.
Honey, stretch it as far as it'll go. We all like a good stretch.
Oh, definitely.
Amazing. Brilliant.
They're so stunned. It's only like one word. Thanks, Wendy.
Stunning, Claire.
Well, thank you, everyone.
Must be done one of my favourite Cher songs. Yes, I know Cher was not the original.
No, it was Mark Cole.
Okay, I didn't know that.
Anyway, I might be wrong.
I've learned something now. So we're going to pop over to Phippipa Mann to see if she's filled up her man yet. And,
yes, I can't wait for this rap.
She's going to provide us with a rap, a little modern and interpretive
rap. A little bit of rap.
Just hope we're not going to turn there and it's like a present.
Well, you never know.
We're not going to unwrap, so we're fine.
Yes.
And I've got one more song for you if you want it.
Fabulous. We do. We can't wait. So we will be back with you shortly. Have another fruit tea.
I will indeed.
See you in a moment, darling. Don't forget to mute your mic. We're going to go to Phippipa Mann. Some of you have requested. So let us... What's going on here? A good stretch as long as we ping straight back.
If not, there's surgery for that.
Yes, I hear that. To tighten things.
Put an elastic band in there, apparently.
Mm. Bing. Bing dong. Right, we're going to Phippipa Mann.
That's a Chinese exchange student.
Exactly. We're going to go to Phippipa Mann now to see what she has to say for herself.
Hello.
Oh, hello.
Hello. Hi, I'm here live. Hello, welcome back. Hi, I'm live. What's happening?
We're going to go to our man in the field, Phippipa Mann. What's the weather report for today?
Hi, guys. How are you? They're like, and now we're going to go live with our correspondent over in London.
Yes.
And they're like...
I want more fucking money. I want more money.
Oh, hi, we're live. How are we doing? Yes, I'm here in London. Thank you for your... Like, how bad is the delay? Like, I know it's BBC, so it's like, you know, taxpayers' money, but fucking hell. Like, honestly...
Right.
Anyway, how are we?
We are good. Apparently, I've got the wrong banner up. Everyone's a critic. Let me go back to your banner. Please hold. There we go. So sorry for the delay.
I wouldn't have known. Can't read.
Don't know. Can't read.
We love running joke. You know I don't run.
Tell us about this rap story. Where did that start?
Okay, so you know on like the later seasons of Drag Race where they have like a finale number where it's like the queens will do like a rap verse on Ru's song.
Yeah.
I quite liked that when they added it in. I was like, oh, this is fresh, this is new, we love this, hello. And I was very, very much like, oh, So we are writing our own lyrics. We aren't just a bunch of men in, you know, wigs, you know, down in the deep end's basement singing, you know, songs that someone has written, like Cher's, you know, Farewell Tour Part 85, you know. We are actually writing our own lyrics and we're actually doing actual songs, and some of us are becoming actual recording artists, which when I was younger, I really loved, I loved to like dream about it when I was younger. And I'd imagine myself on like, what's it called? The Tonight Show, the Late Late Show with James Corden, you know, being there like, yes, and my new album comes out Monday. You know, like that, like that's the thing. Like, I would imagine myself like being in interviews at like, when I was like 11, you know? So yesterday, and yeah, so that's where it's kind of come from, my kind of full dream that I've wanted to do since I was younger, and then also seeing that it is possible for someone like me to actually pursue it.
Cool.
You could always develop a female rap artist, call her Eminem.
Feminem, oh yeah.
And note, it's not the tablet you take for period pains.
Right. It could be. I mean,
who knows? So tell us about the rap that you're about to do for us.
Yeah, I wrote it as if I was going to be on, like, you know, season 3 of UK Drag Race, in the top 3, top 4, whichever one I'm going to do, because you know what they're like. And I wrote it as if I was going to be on there, and I was going to be like, this is my rap, this is time for my choreography time, you know. And then I started putting it to actually an actual song. I put it to Say So by Doja Cat. I love that song so much. And I wrote a verse for the first four verse, obviously, and I wrote a verse for the second verse, and it kind of was like, oh, I'm decent at this. I quite like the sound of it. I want to keep doing this even more, rather than just, you know, being there like, I'm fierce and slay, and yes, uh-huh, and that's me, because I'm on top 3. Like, I was actually like, oh, actually, if I come with actual lyrics that actually means something to me, I can, through storytelling, do kind of more with myself than just...
And it's this. Those kind of queens that endear people. You know, yeah. The ones that show a little bit of kind of...
You know what? It's the technical skill and the ability, and then the humility as well.
Yeah. Oh, because yeah,
they put so many words into a rap, as we all know. You kind of squash 20 sentences into one verse.
Yeah.
But they do it in such a way that if you listened to the words, you'd be horrified at how accurate their rap is to them, and how unique it is to them, and how they bring in all the nuances of what's gone on before to get to where they are.
Yeah.
So really, really cool. So with that, do you have a backing for this, or is it just you rapping?
No, I'm just going to rap, because I couldn't find a track, because I don't know how I would link it with this, and I'm not a technical guru.
No,
so,
we aren't.
No. Obviously.
We don't pretend to be. That's how we lost our screen for 5 minutes.
Love it. But you know, so I'm just gonna do it. Sans, you know, bit of French for you here. Bit of sans track.
Ooh la la.
Cool. So we are gonna give you the full screen.
Oh great.
And take it away. Phippipa Mann doing her thing, rapping like she means it, honey.
Hello. Oh, it's gone so quiet, I can't hear him. All right. So this rap I wrote a few months ago, and I really loved it, and I've been trying to work on more rap since then. I'm trying to put like an EP, like an album type of thing. So I hope you guys enjoy this. All right. Born from the ashes I rise. All eyes on me, bitch. When I arrive, I'm a bad bitch who's new in town. And you know I'm coming for that crown, because if hot in hearing who's, I ain't hearing the hoes. I'm the baddest bitch, just thought you should know. Coming up quick and coming up slick, reclaiming what's mine, reclaiming my time. If you want dope, then believe that I'm the digger. If you want to fire, then believe that I'm the trigger. No birthday, but I'm caking money that I'm making. Roll up to the bank, because you know I ain't faking. Ooh, you thought that I was playing? That's on you, boo, because you were just hating. Why you're mad, because your face is deflating. Why you're sad, is it because you ain't relating? That's literally it.
Well done!
Peppa wants to be your backup dancer. Yes. She's got a whole rap worked out.
Yes. Choreographic, you know, you can be my choreographer. That's the one. No, but my choreography captain. Choreographic captain. I don't know, I'm dyslexic.
dance captain.
Yeah, but we're going to give a fancier name.
Wear my pom-poms.
Thank you, Howard.
Well done, says Howard. Mm-hmm. Anita says, so freaking cool, yes.
Ooh.
So, what do you believe? Do you have any... You have a drag daughter. You told me the other day you have a drag
daughter. Yeah, I do. I do have a drag daughter, and I love it a bit. Her name is Clementine. Right. You can find her on Instagram and TikTok, both Clementine. And she is the most adorable child in the entire world. I love it a bit. Her mug is beautiful. She's starting her own wigs as well. Her performance skills aren't the best. That's why I'm her mother. I teach her these things. And she is so adorable. I met her right at Weymouth Pride last year. And she wasn't doing drag then. And she came up to me and was like, excuse me, are you Phippipa Mann? And I was like, I am. And she was like, hi, I'm, you know, what her username is to be on Instagram. And I was like, can mum, give mum a squeeze, can mum? And she was so adorable because I have such a passion for the kind of queer youth, because they are maybe thrown out by their families, not accepted, not loved, not felt welcomed by people.
Yeah.
Which is something that their straight counterparts will never experience, you know? And I feel it's unfair, and I feel like they need a family, they need somewhere to explore and be themselves and actually realize that who they are is not an issue. It's other people's opinions and beliefs. I love the queer youth.
I don't know whether you saw one of our previous videos where I was saying that out of this, I actually work in a school and co-run the LGBTQ group.
Yeah.
And we've done it from such a way that we wanted the students to know that there are adults in their local surroundings who are non-binary, who are bisexual, gay, transgender. And literally these kids' minds have been blown at the fact that they're actually people that know what they're going through.
Exactly,
and be there for them to talk to.
And it's been a safety net for them as well.
Mm.
Exactly. I mean, because when I was growing up, I mean, which was obviously like 2 minutes ago, I just finished school. I haven't worked when I finished this. But like when I was younger, I didn't have that sort of safety net. I didn't have that sort of like blanket of any adults around me that I knew. I mean, I had my mum's friends who were, you know, that's my mum's friend. Is he, you know, like, and like
Uncle Bill and Uncle Mavis.
Yeah. Like, you know, and I never had any sort of like, I guess, role models, I would say, of anyone in the queer community. So giving children and giving young queer people that sort of, I guess, symbol is, even that is just a lot to them and can do wonders. You know?
Exactly.
I don't think you ever know how much you touch someone's life until you've walked a mile in their shoes.
Yeah.
And it's really, really, really important in this day and age that people do, if nothing else, people need to communicate, validate and appreciate others for their uniqueness.
Exactly.
Not for what they can do for you, but for what they are struggling to do for themselves. The fact that we get up out of bed every single day and face the challenges that we face, you know, on a day-to-day basis, be us, be you, gay, bisexual, straight, transgender, you know, Ethiopian, Martian, whatever, it doesn't matter. I think everybody really needs to be the best version of themselves that they can actually be, you know, and that will really, really play through for them in the long run, really.
I mean, I've always said, like, you know that thing where it's like, it takes, you know, more muscles to frown than it does to smile, like, it takes more effort to hate someone for being who they are than it does to accept them.
Absolutely.
Like, it's just, I mean, I'm probably very privileged that I grew up with learning to accept everyone for who they are, whereas other generations haven't had that, you know, sort of education. is Lady wearing a turban? Sorry. I had to pause on that one real quick.
Wait.
Is that turban or turdon?
Wait, Adam is on our show next week as Rhea Search. wait until you get on my show, bitch. Wait. I'll have you know this is a double stack. Or a stack, sorry.
Yeah.
It's a stack.
McDonald's delivered it.
Because, Adam, you are cruising. Just be you. Thank you, Lisa. Absolutely. Well, that wrap was phenomenal. And we're going to come back to you in a little bit. Have another swing of your tea. Oh, apparently it's a Russian hat. Anybody else want to have a go at my wig? Careful.
I will.
Sorry, what is it again? Philippa, what did you say?
I would.
Ooh, shady lady.
Guess who controls this screen?
Love you, Philippa.
My dear, dear, dear loyal subjects, loyal people. We're going to go over now to Rude. Paula Davies. I used to love you, Paula Davies. Skullcap. Rude.
This alien is a gorgeous skull.
This is a gorgeous hairdo. I mean, really? Why are people having a go at me? Rude.
They're just being
realistic.
Yeah.
You're next on the chopping block. Right, I'm going to go to my sister Clair Mydia because I'm sure she won't be rude to me. Hello, gorgeous.
Hello.
These bitches are saying I'm wearing a turban now. I mean, really?
Tell them to fuck off.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. And of course, you've got Liz piping up with, where has she gone? Love Pepper's hair, of course.
It's all natural.
Soul cap? So rude. Skull cap, she said. Skull.
Yeah, what's a soul cap?
I have no idea what a soul cap is. So, Claire, we would love to have you back again. Don't lose touch. I'm going to be pestering you anyway because I think you and I have become sisters for life. Because I really love your sense of humor. And your sister
can play too. Anytime you want me to come on the show, I shall be there.
Fabulous. Tell us, what are you going to sing for us as your last song for this evening?
I was going to sing I Am What I Am, but I can't find a backing track for that. So instead, I'm going to sing Zero to Hero. I sung this on Tina D's Cup of Tea with Tina D for a Disney edition last week or the week before. So yeah, I'll get used to it as well.
Sorry, what was that?
Zero to Hero from Hercules. That's what I'm singing.
Oh, Zero to Hero from Hercules. Yes, she had a Disney episode. For those of you that don't watch Tina D. Parsons' show, she had a Disney show, and all the drag queens sang different Disney songs, which was lovely. So you're going to sing Zero to Hero from Hercules. Now, we are going to pop comments on screen whilst you're doing your thing. Again, I haven't got the right ticker tape before Adam moans at me and gets a slap. Hold on. Let's make sure we got the right lady with the right... There we go. Clair Mydia's contact details are below. Feel free to tip her. Feel free to get in contact with her Instagram, PayPal, Facebook. She is a lovely lady to know. So, all that remains to say is Zero to Hero from Hercules by the gorgeous, the one and only... Our new soul sister, all the way from Wales, by way of Manchester. Love Clair Mydia.
Thank you, darling.
Holy yeah, bless my soul. Earth was on a roll, earth and all the winking, every creek and pinhole. What a pro, earth could stop a show, pointing at a monster and you're talking SRO. He was a no was, now he's a hot shot, he is our hero. He was the kid we react down past. Zero to hero, in no time back. Zero to hero, just like that. When he smiled, the girls went wild with oohs and ahs. And his face on every face of every bar. From appearance fees and royalty, I heard that cash in burn. Now you will reach and fame, he can tell you what the Grecian earned.
say amen. There he goes again, sweet and undefeated, and an awesome 10 for 10. Go right up, just to watch him play. And the perfect pocket takes a pair of pretty backs. And he comes, he sees a conquer. Hot in the crowd, we're going bonkers. He kills a moxie, brains and spot. Zero to hero, a major hunk. Zero to hero, and to the funk. Who was the Latin gladiator? Whose very deeds are crazy hitter? Isn't he bold? Isn't he sweet? Hercules, 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 Hercules. Bless my soul, Hercules on the road. On DCM, right in high, I'm the nicest guy. He was a nothing, now he's a hot shot. He's our hero, at breakneck speed. Zero to hero, Hercules a hero. Now he's a hero. Oh, 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 oh. Yes, indeed.
Thank you very much.
Stunning. Stunning, stunning, stunning.
Thank you.
Your sister says, my favorite song. And Adam says, work queen.
Thank you.
I love Claire's too. Hair. Liz loves your hair.
Thank you.
And Paula Davis so is trying to backtrack by telling me she loves me. I'm not sure. So... where can people find you? I mean, we're all still locked in, so people can probably find you here again soon, hint hint.
Yes.
Also, you are planning a Christmas show. Would you like to plug that?
I am indeed, yeah. I'm planning a Christmas drag extravaganza online show for the 18th of December. So I'm bringing together about 12 different drag acts and drag artists, and they're all going to grace us with a Christmas themed performance. And you'll get a few performances from myself throughout the night as well.
And I shall be singing on that show.
You will indeed.
I have been asked to sing.
Forward to very much. Sorry, say that again.
We can hear babies.
Yes, Charlie, my little nephew, just walked in the room, so Carl's just crying now.
Hello. She was just there with you in your house.
Yeah, he's staying at ours tonight, Charlie.
Oh, lovely.
Yeah.
Really lovely. With Auntie Claire.
Yes, he loves Auntie Claire.
Right.
He does, he loves sitting and watching me get ready, and he's got his own little bits of makeup that he puts on himself, so he likes to take whatever you're doing, so I've got a little bag of Pussy Cat wigs, so that whenever I'm done up, he can put a wig on and whatnot, he loves it.
Amazing. Oh, I'm losing all my earrings and everything. Amazing, amazing, amazing. And where did that go? Benita says I think she's holding her hands up to you. I think that's what that is. Yes. Okay. Leon says, you're my hero. Now, Leon is Flixie Bell, who lives near you in Shrewsbury. And he is going to be performing as Flixie Bell with us in a couple of weeks' time. So look out for that.
Oh, I wait to see.
Yeah, beautiful song, says Liz Waldron. So thank you.
What's going to do Poor Unfortunate Souls, but I didn't know, so I just chose that one.
Oh, we might have to have an encore.
Well, yeah, if you want it, I'll pull it up and we'll do that for an encore if you like.
Cool. Let's go and see what the lovely Phippipa Mann's doing for a bit, and then we'll come back to you, and maybe you can do Poor Unfortunate Souls. And then don't forget, Claire, after the show, we're going to go back onto our...
on the Zoom call.
Onto our Zoom call for people that might want to ask us questions afterwards as we de-drag a bit. So if you don't have to do that, that's fine too. But we would love to have you with us.
Fabulous.
So if you'd like to do an on-call, absolutely. Mm-hmm. Let's go and see what Phippipa has to say. Hi. Oh.
That's not very ladylike.
Not very ladylike at all. Oh, dear.
I'm quite disgusted. Oh. Nice flies are back.
crowd control. Oh, my Buddha.
Daycare.
My aching ovaries. Let's see what that Phippipa Mann has to say for herself.
Girl, that was breathtaking. I love that. That was absolutely beautiful. That was, I love that song so much, honestly. Like, if I was at a bar right now and that was a live performance, you know, and I could go up and touch her, I wouldn't. But I would throw my bra at her had I been wearing one.
Lovely. Lovely, lovely, lovely. So classy you are. Love it.
I don't even go to school either. I don't know what class is. Yes.
It's because she can't spell it.
Where do you find your material, Phippipa? Because you're a funny queen.
I've always been very quick-witted. Yeah, I've always been very quick-witted, and I've always like, I think because of having to, we're going to get real dark now. So when I was younger, when I came out, I wasn't exactly accepted, and I think the comedy and the humour were, I guess, like for a lot of people, deflections of that.
Yes.
So I think being able to snap back and quick and that sort of stuff. And also when I was younger, everyone was like, you're gay, you must be sassy, you must be bitchy. So I learned how to become that. But obviously I've taken it in as a personality trait, and I've just been taking it as a sense of like, oh, actually, well, once I left school, I was like, actually, no need to be a bitch about everything, just be a nice person and have funny moments, not, you know, horrible, like, you know, sassy yass moments, what everyone wants to see, you know. So I think it comes from that, actually. And also I like to take me, because to me comedy is the best medicine as well.
Yeah,
so definitely. I've always been there, like, oh, I don't like doing serious drama pieces. Fanny Center love, sorry, that's
that's our sister Penny Crillock.
Yes.
I've always been there, like, I'm more of a comedy person because I like to make sure when I'm performing, people have a laugh and get taken on the journey with me and escape whatever they're, you know, feeling when they walk in the room.
Yeah, I think there's a big difference with laughing with people than laughing at people.
Yeah, exactly.
You and I, through school, were laughed at because we were different.
Mm.
But to turn that around and to have the ability to get people to laugh with you rather than at you, yes, it deflects the attention and the bullying, but it also is an art form. Mm. Not many people get it right, and certainly not many young people. And it keeps sounding like I'm being funny with you tonight. I'm not actually being patronizing.
Oh, no, no.
It's refreshing to find a younger queen who can hold her own.
Ooh, that's a good light, sorry. Cheekbone for days. Sorry. As you were.
Talking about queens being distracted about Instagram and light, and this is my light, and I found my moment.
I'm sorry, carry on, sorry.
That's right. Honestly, Peppa, it's really refreshing these days to find a younger person who can laugh at you with you, take you on a journey, and still know who they are at the end of it. Yeah. And I think so many queens are so busy clicking at people and giving attitude.
Oh,
yeah. All the tongue pops, the clicks, the death drops.
I love it. But being like that isn't exactly a personality trait. Like, unless it's like I'm being an asshole now, being like that's not, you know, but like, if that's who you are, that's who you are. But like, you know, that's what a lot of media portrays us as, you know, as this, like, yes, you go get your mare, honey. Oh, crrr. Like, that's not who we are.
No.
Like, I told a customer at work yesterday to fuck off. Like,
that's we what are, customer like, relations.
Well, you know, we're not people like, yes, honey, would you like a bag with that? Oh, crrr. We're not that kind of people. Like, we are people just like the straights. Like, I mean, a delivery driver got my, took my order on the block the other day when I ordered Wagamama's. And I was like, did you want to get me, do you want to get a sat nav for Christmas, love? Did you want a sat nav for Christmas, did you? Like, because I will buy you one so you can get my order on time and run at the fucking right house. Honestly. Like, we're all assholes like the straights are. So, this whole entire persona of, yes, mommy, yes, queen, I'm feeling my out, oh, crrr, I'm setting my pussy up. That's not, like, it's not us. It's a stereotype. And it gets me because, like, it's not who we are, people. Do you know what I mean?
Specializing going to the door, Deliveroo, or any other services there with the meal, and then suddenly going, thank you, death drop.
Yeah. Yeah. They're like Wagamamas for Philippa. I'm like, yes, Mama, you better come through. You better serve the children, Mama. Oh, crrr, you know, down I go. Like, no, ma'am. I'm gonna like, thank you. I'm hungry.
Yeah.
Door closed. Like, you were late.
Speaking as a woman of a certain age, I think if I did a death drop at the door, that would be me. Death at the door. There wouldn't be further communication. That would be the end of the show. Thank you. Good night.
It's probably what I do if I fall down the stairs.
What is this, darlings? Says David Parkinson. Oh, David, if you only knew what Fanny has to do for the... what we've decided.
Yes.
David, if you only knew what we've decided that Fanny has to do for our Hello Queen
murder mystery.
We've found you such a lovely part. I can't wait to share that with you.
The information's wrong on below. God.
Oh.
I took a course in reading, sorry. I had to do it.
I don't think you can read or anything.
Yeah, I had to take a course in reading because, well, my benefits ran out yesterday, so I've got to go and act as if I'm going to get a job. Like...
Oh, I think you've got a future in comedy. That's definitely what you've got.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I like like dipping my toes in the water of comedy, you know?
Dip your toes.
What, they're nice toes. Look, see, they're lovely toes.
Oh, look, not only Flexibel can lift her leg up above her head.
Oh, that's as far as I can go. But I'm literally in jeans and like, that's like, from here home, I'm like, I'm a lady. You guys think I'm wearing a whole outfit? And they're like, no, jeans and socks. Like, do you know what I mean?
Comfort.
Honestly. Well, it's so important to be comfortable.
Pippa's wearing tracky bottoms, so really.
Well, exactly. My
she's my in her 80s gear above.
I mean, I think like you can't see from the belly button up.
Well, for us, you can't see from the boobs up.
Oh down. Yeah, but that's because they droop so low. I'll see myself out. I'm sorry. I'll see myself out. Never mind. Bye. Thanks. Nice having you. Like.
Well, it's been lovely having you with us. Don't go anywhere. If you want to do the post show Zoom call, then let us know. But
I would, but I'm on with a bunch of straight people downstairs. Sorry. Don't know. Wow. No, they were watching football and being lads, and it's so gross. I'm pretty sure none of them wash their fucking ass. It's gross. I hate the straights. TM. If you're straight and you're watching this and you support the quiz, I don't mean you. If you're a straight man, is that like I hate the gays. God is right. Like.
Right, well, while you're having a moment to gather yourself,
yes,
we shall go and do Poor Unfortunate Souls from
I Can't Wait, Mist. My favourite song.
Right, well, you get yourself ready for our finale. Mwah. Bye, darling.
Bye, love you.
We might bring you back in for a little background dancing for Chlamydia's song. Is Claire even there? Claire? Oh, she's not even at her screen. God. Oh, she's gone.
She's dropped out. She's a poor, unfortunate soul.
Oh, dear.
Not sure. And now a word from our sponsor whilst we find Claire.
Yes.
Yes.
Tea. Drink it.
Right, so boys and girls, we're not sure where Claire's gone to, actually.
Yes, it's a bit like Where's Wally, but...
She's literally just disappeared off our screen.
Mm. Yes, so what have we got coming up next week?
Next week, we have... Sure, she'll be delighted.
She will.
Next week we have let my brain engage for a moment. We have research or research, but I call her research. And we have another surprise guest.
Ooh.
Not gonna say too much about that, but we do have a full complement of guests booked in for next week.
What about that new scullery maid that you've got in the house?
Oh, Annalise, she's not on next week. She's suspiciously absent. I think she's busy servicing the stall.
Yes, I'd heard she'd been around all the stable boys.
Oh, all of them?
Filthy mare she is.
I have 56 stable boys.
She's a busy girl. That's why your scullery never gets cleaned.
Dear. Well, let's go to Clair Mydia for her finale song. She's back with us. Woo. Live on screen. Hello, baby.
Oh. Hello. My phone died.
Oh.
So, just to get on the other one. So, I'm back.
Right, let me get the right banner up before I get moaned at by everyone. Everyone is a critic tonight, Claire. Everybody's having a moan about my hair, about the wrong banner being up for the wrong person. I mean, don't they understand we have a whole staff of one?
But you know what I say? Opinions are like arseholes. Everyone's got one, don't mean you want to see it.
You can stay, I love you. Oh, we've got someone watching from Indonesia. Hello, Derry Panaka.
Hello.
Hi. No idea how we got all the way to Indonesia, but we did. We're very international. I love Philippa and Claire, but obviously not as much as I love Peppa. Oh, dear. Right, so poor unfortunate souls from The Little Mermaid. In it?
Yes. In it.
In it.
Mermaid,
so this is Claire's final contribution for the evening. She's doing Poor Unfortunate...
What are you like?
Teeth back in, love. Teeth back in.
Oh, my aching ovaries.
You've had too much Captain Muffin in your mouth. That's what it is.
Oh, Captain. So, Poor Unfortunate Souls. From Clair Mydia. Take it away, my love.
My dear sweet child, that's what I do. It's what I live for. To help unfortunate merfolk like yourself. Poor souls with no one to turn to. I admit that in the past I'd been a nasty. They were kidding when they called me, well, a bitch. But you'll find that nowadays I've mended all my ways. Repented, seen the light and made a switch to, yeah. And I fortunately know a little magic. That's a talent that I always have possessed. And dear lady, please don't laugh. I use it on behalf of the miserable, the lonely and depressed. Pathetic, poor unfortunate soul. In pain, in need. This one longing to be fair, that one wants to be a girl. Do I help them? Yes, indeed. Those poor unfortunate souls, so sad, so true. They come flocking to my cauldron, crying spells as the please, and I help them. Yes, I do. Now it's happened once or twice, someone couldn't pay the price. They're afraid I had to rake them across the cold. Yes, I've had the odd complaint, but on the whole I've been a saint to those poor unfortunate souls. Have we got a deal? But you'll have your man. Life's got a tough choices, isn't it? Oh. There is one more thing. We haven't discussed the subject of payment. You can't get something for nothing, you know. I'm not asking much, really. Just a token, a trifle. What I want from you is your voice. You'll have your looks, your pretty face. And don't underestimate the importance of body language. The men up there don't like a lot of blabber. They think a girl who gossips is a bore. Yet a lad is much preferred for ladies not to say a word. And after all they want is idle babble for. Come on there, not all that impressive conversation. True gentlemen avoid when they can. but they dote into the court on a lady who's withdrawn. It's she who holds the time that gets a map. Come on, you poor fortunate soul. Go ahead, make your choice. I'm a very busy woman and I haven't got all day. It won't cost much, just your voice. You poor fortunate soul. So sad, so true. If you want to cross the bridge, my dear, you've got to pay the toll. Pick a note, take a breath, go ahead and sign the scroll. Lady D, Peppa, the boss is on a roll. These poor unfortunate souls.
Jesus.
Yay! You've had offers. You've had offers, Claire.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Flixie Bell wants to know, can I be Ariel to your Ursula?
Any day.
That Lisa girl has said love, love, love. And Rhea Search has said, if Leon is Ariel, can I be Sebastian?
So only when we're under the sea. He
wants to give you crabs, dear.
Anytime. I'll have your crabs if you have my chlamydia. Deal?
Caring,
too
sharing.
Funny. Too funny. So do you have anything else planned before the 18th of December? Have you got any other shows that you're going to be on? Or any makeup tutorials that you're doing? Shorter ones?
I've not got any plans that have booked me as yet, but I'm hoping that's going to change in the next couple of weeks. But yeah, I might be doing a couple more live videos, a couple more makeup ones, not 5 hours long this time. Yeah, do another makeup tutorial, be a bit more informative and go into detail as to what I actually do to make my face. If anyone's interested in learning how I paint my face, then you can come and watch me.
Amazing. Amazing, amazing, amazing. Well,
and I've really enjoyed being on tonight with you. So really have.
We've loved having you on with us this evening. In fact, if we do that and do that.
Hey!
Hi, babies. How are you doing?
So we'd like to say thank you, ladies, for being with us.
Thank you for having me.
Let's take that down. Let's do, before someone moans at me about a banner. Fiona Flange is up.
I absolutely loved your rap, Philippa. I thought it was absolutely amazing.
I mean, your voice is incredible.
Can't wait to hear more from you.
Amazing.
Maybe you might.
See, at least I've done my research. Right. So, ladies, we'd like to thank you for being with us tonight. We hope that you've enjoyed the evening with us and that you've had fun.
Yeah. We've loved having both of you with us as well.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Oh, it's been a pleasure.
I loved it.
And we'd love to have you back again on Live Lounge with Lady Martinique and Peppa Sprey.
Yes, I'd love to be a regular.
Yeah, each week we're coming to you from a different room in Martinique Manor. As you know, I have extensive premises.
It's a lot of land. Yes.
Peppa Sprey is my personal assistant.
Next week, should we be in the West Wing?
Yes. We might. We were thinking of doing we're doing a bathroom next week, and let's tell you why. Because next week we're doing Hello Sailor as our theme.
Hmm? Hello Sailor!
We're having a nautical theme. Lots of seamen.
Mm-hmm.
Lots of
all that seamen, and you didn't invite me?
Rude.
Well, you might get a call back, dear. Stay by your phone.
Mm-hmm. I will do.
And you can come on back.
Yes.
Love it, Claire. You're amazing. Mm-hmm. Did your research. We need a Claire song with Philippa Rapp. Oh, little cool.
Collaboration.
Next week, Lady M is in the bathroom. Yes, we are in the bathroom next week because we are doing Hello Sailor. Hello Sailor is our theme next week. So both of us are doing a nautical theme because today we discovered that this young lady had decided on 80s and I'd already decided on this wig. Although it's no critical acclaim, it lots of
blah, 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 blah.
Lots of insults. So we've decided to combine forces and come up with a weekly theme. Wakanda Forever.
Wakanda.
Wash That Man Right Out of My Hair song next week. Oh, we might do that, actually. Oh.
And send him on his way.
We might actually do something like that, Paula Davies. Are you tuning in next week? There's no semen without chlamydia. Lovely. Right, so ladies and gents, we'd like to thank our guests for this evening. We've been over thank the two-hour mark. If you want to join us on Zoom next week as a backstage guest, we go live at 6 o'clock and do our dress-up and sort-out and make-up from 6 till about 7:30 with our guests. And you can join us and chat to them as they're getting ready. And then we close at 7:30. We're going to do that because tonight we had a bit of a technical issue. So we're going to close at 7:30 and then go live at 8 for the show. So we've got half an hour so that we can do the final touches to what we need to do.
Yeah, and anyone that's watching the repeats of the show from anywhere in the world, please let us know where you are and if you're enjoying the show.
Yeah.
And please get your friends, family, dogs, cats, neighbours, nannies, granddads, postmen, watch the show.
And don't forget, you know, we love to hear from you guys. We especially love that this week we got two parcels in the post. One was a lovely contribution of vouchers. We won't say how much, yes. But mm-hmm. it was staggering.
Yes.
It was staggering. Lovely, lovely contribution of vouchers as a little thank you for what we do. And also we got a lovely chain and pepper engraved on the chain for the lovely Peppa. She got a special parcel in the post. So we'd love to thank our fans for sending us fan mail, send us post, send us knickers. No, don't send us knickers.
pants.
Oh, but send nudes.
No.
Yes.
Send me nudes. We don't want to see your winky jinas or your front bottoms, we've decided. No. You can keep those to yourself. But those of you that would like to join us on our Zoom call, it's an extended call, so it's before the show and then after the show. So if you were watching this evening before the show and you had a backstage pass for the show, why not join us now afterwards where we are de-dragging and chatting all shit about the show. So thank you, thank you, thank you. Please take care of yourselves and each other. Look after yourselves this week. And we look forward to seeing all of you again next week here on Live Lounge at Martinique Manor. Watch the Facebook pages for details of exactly what to expect. Mm-hmm. Thanks, guys. Thanks, ladies.
Yes.
Bye.
Bye.